Hi there, welcome back to our channel. If you are new here, I am Sharath Chandar. I aim to teach you about full stack software development. Therefore, I create weekly project videos that make programming easier. And today we are celebrating the completion of a massive challenge, 52 weeks of 52 projects in JavaScript. That's right, one project every single week for an entire year. It's been an incredible journey full of challenges, learning and lot of coding, and I am super excited to share some of the highlights with you. First off, I want to thank each and every one of you who has been following along, whether you have been here from week one or just joined recently. And I could not have done it without our amazing community. Your comments, feedbacks and encouragement keep me going week after week. Now let's start with the journey itself. 52 weeks of non-stop coding, learning and problem solving. Over the past 52 weeks, we have tackled everything from basic JavaScript projects to more advanced topics like consume APIs and working with advanced games. We have exploring a wide range of unique topics and categories. We started with simple project like a to-do list and a weather app, then progressed to more complex one like a Gemini clone. Each project taught us something new, whether it was about JavaScript itself, best coding practices, or how to think like a developer. Here, a quick breakdown of the categories we covered. First, JavaScript projects for beginner to advanced. In this playlist, we have created projects from simple calculator, mini text editor as a sticky note, to OTP generator, OTP validator, and much more. Here, we can learn about DOM manipulation and displayed dynamic data using JavaScript, save and retrieve data using local storage. Second, animating access with HTML, CSS and JavaScript. In this playlist, we have created projects from animated login and sign up form with validation and responsive top navigation, side navigation bar and much more. Here we can learn about CSS animations, client-side validations and responsive design and development. Third, JavaScript project for clocks. In this playlist, we have created clocks from digital to analog with alarm features, countdown app and dynamic calendar. Here we can learn about JavaScript data objects and functions with how to use set interval and set timeout based on the time duration. Fourth, responsive personal portfolio website. In this playlist, we have created projects such as websites, responsive personal portfolio, and responsive admin dashboards. Here we can learn more about CSS media query to create a responsive website for different devices like mobile to Windows. Fifth, JavaScript games. In this playlist, we have created simple games from dynamic memory card to advanced Flappy Bird game using Canvas. Here we can learn about how to create static games and advanced Canvas games to draw graphics, and how JavaScript makes it actionable on the fly. Out of all 52 projects, a few stand out as my personal favorite. Let me share those with you and let us know your favorite in our comment box below. First, Google Gemini clone using JavaScript. This project was a personal favorite because this was both challenging and exciting. Incorporating AI with API to ask a questions or make request, and it will respond with text, code or images. It's open up a whole new world of possibilities using JavaScript. Second, e-commerce website with AutoCode. We connected to a public fake store API and displayed real-time store data and added items into the cart. This project was a great way to understand how to work with APIs and asynchronous JavaScript. Third, software engineer portfolio. We built a silk response wants your portfolio that not only showcases your work but also includes interactive elements like an embedded blog and a contact form. Fourth, word guessing game. This classic game was so much fun to create. We implement it using only vanilla JavaScript and it turned out great. Fifth, Flappy Bird game. This game is designed to appear to be played in real time with flying bird and background music. It is constructed using JavaScript on top of canvas. Each of these projects pushed me out of my comfort zone and gave me a deeper understanding of JavaScript and software development. Now, what did I learn from doing 52 projects in 52 weeks? Let me break down the key takeaways. Consistency is key. The biggest lesson, consistency. Working on a project every week might have been challenging, but it really helped build strong habits. Time management. One of the biggest challenges was time management. Balancing coding with everyday life is not easy, but sticking to a schedule and being disciplined was crucial. Learning on the go. Not every project went smoothly and I often had to learn new concepts quickly. This taught me the importance of being a lifelong learner. Learn by doing. There is no substitute for hands-on practice. Every project was an opportunity to reinforce what we have learned. Community support. I could not have done this without your support. The comments, feedback, and encouragement from the community kept me motivated every single week. We have built an amazing community here where everyone helps each other out. Don't forget to use your piece as resources, whether it's for debugging or brainstorming new ideas. Code reusability. I realized the importance of writing clean, modular code. Many components from early project were used in later ones, saving time and effort. Even the most complex project became manageable if you break it down into smaller actionable steps. I also learned that breaking down problems into a smaller manageable task makes a huge difference, and perhaps the biggest takeaway was that the learning never stops. Even now, I constantly discovering new things and refining my skills. So, what's next for the channel? Just because the 52-week challenge is over does not mean we were stopping here. I have some exciting new series and projects in the pipeline. We are going to continue building, learning, and exploring the world of programming languages. Stay tuned because the best is yet to come. For more exciting coding challenges, tutorials, and maybe even another long-term series like this one, I have added all the project links into a single playlist into the description. If you are interested, please do check it out. If you have any questions, suggestions, or ideas, drop them in the comments. Before we wrap up, I want to say a huge thank you again to everyone who's been a part of this series, whether you have been here since week one or just joined. Your support means the world. I have loved seeing your progress and hearing about the projects you have created. If you have not already, make sure to hit the subscribe button and ring the bell so you don't miss what's coming next. Here's to more coding, more learning, and more creating together. And if you liked this video, give it a thumbs up. It really helps the channel. Remember, this is just the beginning. The skill you have honed over these 52 weeks can now be applied to even bigger and better projects. Until then, keep learning, and I will see you in the next video. Happy coding!